Come back out to this point for sundown and camp out past trees on this island and had a nice dinner, and Jerry brought some homebrew moonshine from down in Kentucky there. Yeah, before we're watching three otters play out here. This is just great. An amazing place to spend an August evening. And we have pretty calm seas this morning. We're trying to beat some of the weather, and we're heading for the McCoy Islands, which you see in the distance there. This is day two after we paddled from Green Island up to Big McCoy, and then took a day paddle out around Little McCoy. Now we're just relaxing with a hike around Big McCoy, where I'm standing now. And we're just working our way around the perimeter of the island. Severe weather out here seems on these islands, being the norm, it seems to create a bonsai type effect on the trees. With all the chunks and slabs of granite, it's like a giant Lego set. You can create a little table for yourself there, or a fire pit, or about anything you can think of. We've seen some really ingenious structures out here, which we're happy to use. We're looking at a wind warning today, although it hasn't quite come up. You can kind of see it hitting that less protected tent in the background, which happens to be me. And then the adage, red sky at night, sailor's light, red sky in the morning, sailor's warning. So we got a wind advisory. We'll have a group meeting and decide whether to make a run for Franklin Island today or not. If the group gets up. There was quite a bit of wine drinking last night. I get ready to take down the tent now so we can launch. The wind and the rain has come up a little earlier than expected. And we have about a 5 mile, 6 mile trip going across to the mainland and then down to Franklin Island. So better get on the hump pretty soon. We're waiting for Michelle to catch up here. It's a little wavy out today. Past the big open water. Yep, pretty painless. Direction would be a piece of cake, knock wood. We're just trying to reach the other side now. Baby.